We have more customers today for Alaska seafood than we've ever had. You look at the trust our customers put in Alaska, look at their packaging, look at their menus. They believe their brand is critical to their existence, and they want the word Alaska side by side on their own brands.
Alaska's salmon management was recognized as a worldwide leader. In fact, that's why the Marine Stewardship Council came to the Alaska salmon folks and said, we'd like to certify your fishery as one of the first certified as an iconic species, well-regarded around the world, to help MSC build its brand and recognition.
Since the introduction of eco-labeling in 2000, really what's changed? We were always talking to our customers about sustainability. We used to call it continuity of supply. If they were going to dedicate shelf space and menu items to our product, they needed to know that they were investing in something that was going to be there year after year, that they should expect that they were building something for the future.
One of the fears that the state of Alaska has about these eco-labeling schemes is that they will come to dictate how to manage a fishery. Really, the schemes are supposed to be a reflection of what is sustainable, but not dictate how you conduct the fishery. But inevitably, when a scheme has got a logo or a name that's important in the marketplace, they can use that space to tell the managers what to do. As a result of that, the third-party certification system tends to be pretty responsive to those who are supporting it. And that may or may not be aligned with what is really sustainable.
They're auditors. They're not scientists, right? They don't generate any science. Not one fish more or less is caught because of them. It's all about building their own organization, their own infrastructure, their own brand, and trying to extract value of being in that space between science and consumers.
The problem is that the standards themselves can be changed and manipulated by the owners of the certification system. And so you're faced with a circumstance where whoever's got the influence on the particular certification scheme can cause changes in what they do, which in turn can result in a lack of market access for a particular fishery because the rules have changed.
What we lack is a standard audit. We hope GSSI helps with that. But right now, there's lots of eco-labeling schemes, and all of them have the ability to define their own set of standards for these audits. For those customers, and I don't know that there's a lot of them, that'll go to a website, that'll read the brochures, that'll really look behind the curtain and look at the science. When they do look behind the curtain, they see huge resources, hundreds of millions of dollars that are being spent by the Alaska Department of Fish and Game, NOAA, industry, fishermen. Those are the people that are spending money to generate science to make sure that we have the models in place to have sustainable stocks throughout the Alaska fisheries. We win those consumers. They pick Alaska.